Live from Room 180, this is Dragon TV, and I am your host, Daryl Williams. It's February, the bleakest month of the year. Winter is all around us, and it tends to be for some time if we believe the forecast the recent groundhog shadow sightings have told. A cold and cruel month. February was only given 28 days because it is the most hated month in the year. In fact, early calendar makers hope to reduce the impact of winter by shortening the size of February. Fortunately, February has a bright spot, Valentine's Day. Global greeting cards company Conspiracy, or Ancient Roman Fertility Festival, Valentine's Day is here. It is a chance to make someone in your life feel special at what might easily be your own expense. We here at Dragon TV have put together a special episode to make sure that your Valentine's Day is happy and a successful one. We go to our musical expert in the field to learn more about the best music for this so-called holiday.
Thank you, Daryl. Love. What's love got to do? Got to do with it? What's love but a secondhand emotion? What's love got to do with it? Who needs a heart when a heart can be broken?
I love that song.
What song?
Tina Turner. Didn't she make that movie called What's Love Got to Do with It?
I don't know. I don't wanna give you the wrong impression. I need love and affection. And I hope that I'm not sounding too desperate. I need love and affection. Love, love, love and affection.
That's Rihanna.
L-O-V-E-E-E and affection.
Eddie, are you feeling okay there?
Help, I need somebody help. Not anybody help. You know I need someone help.
Can you only talk in song lyrics?
Near, far, wherever you are, I believe that the heart does go on, and once more you open the door and you're here in my heart, and my heart will go on and on.
Eddie, shake your head if something is wrong.
Never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and hurt you. Never gonna make you cry, never gonna say goodbye, never gonna tell a lie and desert you.
Do you want me to go get the nurse, bud?
Boy, when you're with me, I give you a taste, make it like your birthday every day.
That's strange. We seem to have lost Eddie to technical difficulties. Okay. Dating can be scary, but it doesn't have to be. To soothe the transition into the world of dating, one should first know how to flirt. So we turn to our cultural correspondent in the field, Kathleen, to learn more about the secret art of flirting.
Thanks, Daryl. You're so funny.
Kathleen?
Yeah?
Don't you have a segment on flirting you're supposed to be doing?
Do you want me to do a segment on flirting?
Yes.
Daryl, I was flirting with you. That's what flirting is. OMG, don't you know anything? You're so cute. Do you work out? You have such a great stare. You probably make like a really mean librarian. Mr. Daryl, I have a late book. Must be a bad connection. Flirting isn't easy, but here are some great tips to improve your game. My first tip, smile with eye contact. Your smile tells the world how you feel about yourself, so your smile is always your first way to trick the world into thinking you're a good person.
Kathleen, you're a good person.
Oh, thanks, boy. See, I tricked him. In addition to smiling, it's important to have good posture. Don't cross your arms, because that'll make you look closed off. Another bad idea is the fetal position. No one's going to flirt with you while you're in the fetal position. Assume a more open stance, but not like a guy on the subway. There are a couple flirty gestures you can use. If you're a girl, try the shoulder roll. To form a proper shoulder roll, assume a proper shoulder length distance directly before your target, jerk your shoulder towards the target, snap back your shoulder to have your shoulder touching your ear, then root it back, creating a sensuous popping sound.
I'll wrap that.
Boys can practice winking. Every wink should be delivered also standing with your feet spread shoulder length apart, with your wink aimed in a vertical squat. if you're really interested in someone, try both moves at once. Context is another thing to consider when flirting, because there are times and places that are more conducive to flirting than others. Funerals, car accidents, hospice care, public restrooms are all excellent for their high level of vulnerability, but can be some considered to be tacky. Use a fishing line. A fishing line is a line to use to gauge the interest of someone without fully revealing your interest. My favorite fishing line is the Brazilian technique. It goes a little like this. I had a dream about you last night. The beauty of I had a dream about you last night is it only reveals that your subconscious has noticed the existence of someone. And then you can customize your dream to the person you're talking to.
Psst, Jabril. I had a dream about you last night.
Ew.
I got hit by a bus.
Or you can make your dream a bit more feisty and alluring if they are more receptive.
Psst, Jabril. I had a dream about you last night. You were hit by a bus.
Do some research. Take a peek into their interests and fabricate a new personality around their interests.
Yay, go Seahawks, number one fan. Oh my god, they were so great in the Stanley Cup Finals last year. I love Smashing Pumpkins. Literally, every Halloween, my mom buys me like 30 and I just go outside and I kick them and hit them all.
My last piece of advice is the best advice, and that's this. Practice. It takes a lot of nerve and years to perfect it, so start practicing now. Even people you don't really like. I mean, who cares, right? This is high school.
I had a dream about you last night.
I love you.
I was just kidding.
Way to go, Jabril. That felt good. Back to you, Daryl.
Thank you, Kathleen, for those flirty tips. Let's now pause for a break from our sponsors.
Chào mọi người, chúng tôi là nhóm Sài Gòn Fresh.
Thầy biết múa hả?
Con có nhiều tài năng. Con phải tự tin vào chính bản thân mình.
Lần đầu tiên gặp nó ngoài đường á, nó còn lơ ngơ lắm. Cho nên xem nó như là em gái vậy đó.
Em thấy lo quá à.
Khu vực này sẽ bị giải tỏa và một khách sạn lớn sẽ được xây dựng ở đây.
Sắp tới có một cuộc thi lớn diễn ra. Nếu mà thắng cuộc thi này, tụi con sẽ được ra nước ngoài và thi tiếp. Con nghĩ đó là cơ hội của tụi con.
Why does Valentine's Day take place on the bleakest month of the year? Perhaps it's the bone-chilling, soul-swallowing gloom of the month that drives people into each other's arms. But how much love is too much love? What is the appropriate line for PDA? We turn to our resident expert in the field, Tessa Moore, to learn more about the delicate balance of affection.
Thank you, Daryl. PDA is a complicated issue in any school community. There is always a delicate balance between showing the appropriate levels of affection and showing so much affection that your peers want to vomit just a teensy bit. Here are some clear guidelines for PDA in the forum. Kissing. Avoid kissing. If you for some reason become inflamed with passion, consider kissing them like they do in Europe. Gently brush cheeks with your partner while making a kissy sound and walk away. Just walk away. Handholding. Avoid handholding if physically possible. If you're really feeling frisky and you absolutely have to hold hands, make sure that your hands are very clean and then select an appropriate bag to deposit your hands into. Hugging. Hugging should only be displayed in celebration of GCS achievements or milestones and administered at a 45 degree angle. This is the A-frame hug technique, or the bracing of shoulders. The best hug involves as little touching as possible. Sitting on each other's laps. This is the worst form of offense. Don't do it. She's not a chair. Some better ways to show your affection for the one you love are as follows. High-fiving. Just as effective, or even more effective than kissing or hugging, high-fiving shows that you care without the tedious need of brushing your teeth. Pushing them. Sometimes this guarantees acknowledgement from that special somebody. If you aren't sure how they feel about you, go ahead and push them down the stairs. Not only will they know you exist and that you're interested, but the intrigue will leave them wanting more. Personally, my favorite way to show affection is the old-fashioned way of ignoring them as much as possible. Ignoring someone is the foolproof way to their heart without grossing others out in the process. It's cleaner, safer, and faster. So next time you're going in to kiss her, considering averting your eyes and walking away. You'll be so much more mysterious. Heck, maybe even consider cutting them out of your life completely. In the end, you'll be a whole lot happier, and Forum will be a whole lot less gross. For Dragon TV, I'm Tessa Moore.
Although most GCS students are not old enough or interested in dating, it is important to know how to make the first moves on the dating scene when you finally turn 21. We consult our expert, the technology expert, the man, Patrick Grady, to learn more about the sacred art of wooing.
Thanks, Daryl. The sacred art of wooing is not at all a subtle or nuanced dance.
You're a pirate. Would you keep your parrot on this shoulder or this shoulder?
It was at one point, but in this new media landscape, there's a heightened need to win the attention of that special someone by taking bold action.
Are you a banana? Because I find you appealing.
Because now, you're not just competing with other suitors. You're competing with the entire smartphone market and the World Wide Web. So in the event that you should ever become interested in developing what is known as a relationship between a fellow human, I have two words of advice. Be loud. Crank it up to number 11 and she'll know you're the alpha male. Volume is certainly a good way to draw attention, but being loud doesn't stop there. You should also dress loud. You can appeal to their more primitive instincts by wearing animals and animal parts. I'm not just talking about leather, feathers, and furs. If you really want to make an impression, wear an endoskeleton or a really cute animal's head. Smell loud. Scent, after all, is the strongest sense tied to memory, and you want to be remembered forever. Your cologne or perfume should be so strong that it should be visible to the naked eye. Move loud. All of your movements and gestures should be exaggerated to the extent that you narrowly lose control of your body. This is the most important on the dance floor. But it can be just as effective in the workplace. Another good trick for drawing out the affections of another human being, be unnecessary. Provide unneeded and even redundant attention.
No!
Let me pick that up for you.
Cute.
Go. Provide compliments.
Are you a campfire? Because you're hot and I want some more.
Open automatic doors for her. Warn about things on her face that aren't actually there.
That's like right here now.
Stop blinking. It is vital more than ever before to stand out and make a memorable, potentially scarring impression now because the smartphone industry is only getting bigger and better. The website, Mac Rumors, forecasts that by 2020, the iPhone will largely end conventional dating with its new 3D avatar dating feature. So please, secure your mate now.
Well, that's our show for today, folks. Stay tuned for more stories from your school, community, and the world. I'm Daryl Williams, and this is your moment of zen.
My doctor says I'm lacking vitamin U.
What are you talking about?
Do I have that song?
The camera is recording.
It is? Oh, we should stop it.